Welcome to the WalterFootball.com podcast. This is episode 310. We're doing our week 17 NFL picks against the spread. Hard to believe it's week 17 already. Joined once again by Jacob Kamaker from the Sporting News. Jacob, how are you and how's your week 16?
I'm doing great. I'm also in a state of disbelief that it's week 17. It's been a crazy quick season. My week 16, I had some pretty bad whiffs last week. I didn't lose any. I actually think I made out positive money-wise. My record was only 7-8-1. I missed big time on the Washington game. That one I should have switched to. The whole Dwayne Haskins starting thing should have been more of a red flag for me than it ended up being, and Terry McLaurin being out on top of all that. When you're outplayed by a dude who's been you know, 3 weeks ago was taking like advanced mathematics courses at Old Dominion University. That's usually not a good sign. But that was one of my big whiffs. The Cowboys beating the Eagles stunned me too. So like those were the two biggest losses I had. But you know, I rebounded nicely with the Packers on Sunday night and the Bills on Monday night. So a good little two-game win streak to end the season. And I think based on last week's play, Aaron Rodgers has wrapped up the MVP, which is very nice for me as well.
Yeah, I think Rodgers wanted it like too, especially because Patrick Mahomes is not going to play this week. Like if Mahomes played this week for some reason, if he needed to, and he threw like 8 touchdowns, like I think you might be in danger a little bit, but he's done. So I think Rodgers definitely wrapped it up. And I think the image of him winning in the snow and like putting up 40 points against a good team, I think people are going to remember that. And I think they're going to vote him in for MVP. I actually wrote an article today on the site talking about why I thought Rodgers should win MVP. I actually wrote it before that game. So it was kind of it's a good thing that Rodgers didn't screw up that game, because then that article looked pretty bad. So I went 11-5 in week 16, hit 4 out of the top 5 plays. Jacksonville was a disaster. I got so much hate mail for that pick. They're like, how dare you pick Jacksonville over Chicago? Like you should get another job or something. And I was like, okay, I'll get another job then. And I think that, you know, the Dallas Eagles game that we both got wrong. You know, Fletcher Cox's injury played a huge part in that. Like if Fletcher Cox didn't go down, I think the Eagles still might have won. They were up 14-3 and then he got hurt and then they couldn't put any pressure on Andy Dalton. So I think that really affected that game. So I wouldn't take that loss like too harshly. I think that, heading into that game, I was like, well, let's wait on Cox news. And then Cox was playing and then he got hurt. So.
Yeah, no, that Fletcher Cox injury was pretty brutal, because I remember seeing him sitting on the sidelines. I'm like, oh, he's out. All right. Well, they got an 11-point lead. They should be okay. And then everything went downhill from there.
Yeah. Justin's asking, what happened to the Giants win divisional bet? It's still alive. If the Giants win and the Redskins lose, the Giants will win the division. And what's crazy is that I checked my bookmaker account. And I forgot that I doubled up on that bet. So I actually have $200 to win $3,600 on the Giants winning the division. So I'm going to have to find a way to hedge that. I think I was talking to an emailer. He said I should tease the two games and then that'll give me a good chance to hedge. So I might just do that. Chris says Haskins cleared waivers. He's done. We were talking a little bit about Haskins before, we started recording, and we're saying that maybe the team that plays the Redskins in the first round, if the Redskins get there, maybe they'll sign him and then they'll ask him some questions and he'll probably tell them where the best strip clubs are in Washington.
Yeah, I think some team will take a chance on Haskins. I think he's probably going to end up on a practice squad for the last week of the season, or just sign a reserve future contract to be on a 90-man roster next offseason. But it also wouldn't surprise me if teams look at his maturity and say, that's an issue, we don't want to deal with it. And he kind of waits around on the free agent market until someone's like, all right, there's a ton of upside here. Let's just take a shot on it and see if we can do anything. I mean, teams buy low on young quarterbacks all the time. Like they just give them a shot to compete. So I could see him doing it. I don't think I have faith that he's going to pan out, but you never know. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, some teams definitely going to take a chance on him. I mean, Josh Rosen's got chances. Blaine Gabbert has gotten lots of chances. Blake Bortles was just added to the Rams roster this week because of an injury. We'll get to that game later. So he's going to get a chance. I feel like if Al Davis were still alive, the Raiders would snap him up instantly. But yeah, some team is going to take him. So all right, let's get into the game. So before we do, please hit subscribe or the like button on YouTube or post a comment or share this video with someone who likes football but may not know about the show. It would help us out a lot. So just like word of mouth or interacting some way, liking, commenting would be great. All right. So every game this week is divisional. The NFL started this a few years ago, and I think it's worked out really well. So there's 7 early games. There are 8 late games, and then there's 1 Sunday night game. So let's get into the early slate. The Cowboys at the Giants. This line opened up Cowboys -2.5, and it's up to -3. So who do you like in this game?
So I like the Giants in this one. The main point is a reason we already talked about. Fletcher Cox getting hurt against the Eagles. That's the reason that the Cowboys were able to come back and win that game, because the Eagles couldn't pressure them. I think the Giants are going to have a better time doing that, because the big strength of that defense is their defensive line. Leonard Williams has played well this year, and Dalvin Tomlinson and Dexter Lawrence have both progressed, and they can get a lot of pushback into the backfield. So I think that there's going to be a lot of good stuff there from that unit against what's still a beleaguered Cowboys offensive line. And, you know, I'm not super confident in the Giants offense. Daniel Jones hasn't looked right since suffering those late season hamstring and ankle injuries. And, you know, he didn't look great last week against Baltimore, but maybe with another week to get healthier, he can get going. And honestly, if not, I think that Wayne Gallman can run pretty well on this Dallas defense. This Cowboys defense hasn't been great against the run this year. They've looked better in recent weeks in totality. But, you know, I think that they're going to have trouble with Gallman. So I'm going to be on the Giants here as the underdog. Since we're getting +3, it's a pretty good scenario here. And as Rick mentioned, Joe and his daughter Isla won the J League championship this year. So congratulations to them. I was pulling for them. First championship for them in the 10-year history of our league.
Yeah. Well, congratulations. I don't know these people, but I'm glad they won. So I agree with you on this game. I like the Giants. The only question is something you mentioned, is that we don't know about Daniel Jones's injury right now. Like, he couldn't move at all against the Ravens. But having another week to get healthier, I think that could definitely really help him out. And if he's at least mobile, it could really negate Dallas's only good aspect of the defense, which is getting to the quarterback. So if Jones can avoid some pressure, he can find the receivers who have good matchups in this game. And then you talked about how Fletcher Cox's absence was huge, and like we talked about in the open, the Giants have a good defensive line. They can get pressure on Andy Dalton, who shouldn't get Zach Martin back this week. And I think Dallas is going to be limited. I mean, they've gotten so lucky in recent games. The 2 games before the Eagles game, they got 7 turnovers from the Bengals and the 49ers, and they were outgained in both those games. And then last week, they got lucky with Fletcher Cox getting hurt. So I think this team is very lucky, and I think we're getting some great line value with the Giants. The Giants were -3 on the advance line. Like, now it's Dallas -3. That's a 6-point line move with 2 key numbers. So I think this is definitely a play on the Giants. I just want to see what Daniel Jones's status is. If he's not on the injury report, I think this could be a big play on the Giants.
Yeah, I don't get why one game would swing it by 6 points. And I get it. The Giants didn't look good against the Ravens, and the Cowboys beat the Eagles, which was a surprise. But again, as we've said, there's a reason that the Cowboys made that comeback. And I mean, we can't discount the Ravens. They're starting to look like a much better team right now overall. They are playing some of their best football. So a 6-point line move is pretty insane. So I think it's definitely a play on the Giants. I have one unit down right now, but I could easily see it going up to 3 if Daniel Jones is a full participant in practice by Thursday or something along those lines.
Yeah, I would definitely agree with that. We had a question about why there are no non-Sunday games, and there used to be non-Sunday games in week 17, but then they changed it. And now they don't have any, because they don't want to give an advantage to teams. Like, teams complained, playoff teams, they're like, wait, why do we have to play Monday night? So they kind of moved it around. And so Chris is saying, I need a fresh cut for the week 17 super contest. I'm actually tied for 10th place in the super contest. So pretty stressful in this final week. Gotta make sure I finish well.